talk about what your process would be in coming into a new role in a new district to kind of get your feet on the ground and, you know, sort of understand what the issues are in terms of, you know, different programs, issues that parents might have, like class sizes or, you know, other kind of things that are related to a parent concern about how you're going to address pedagogical issues, you know, educational issues, any transformative issues.
Sure. So the first few months, it's important for me to be inside the schools, talk to the principals and the assistant principals, the leadership team inside of schools to really understand each and every school. While New Rochelle is one school community, each school has a different sort of sense to it, a different sort of culture. And so I really want to get to know what each of those cultures are like, what people value, what do they love about the school, what do they think their next challenges are. And until I can really be an insider in the schools, then that's when I'll understand what the next steps might be for the schools. In terms of parents' concerns and how do we escalate them, it has got to be the expectation that schools handle problems. Certainly things may bubble out that are exceptionally challenging, but you know, there's a plan for teachers to first and foremost support students, and that schools to be able to respond to the concerns of parents. Broader concerns, of course, are ones for the Board of Education and for the superintendent, and those are things we'll address as they come up.
Okay, well, it's easy to ask you about all the problems. So I'm going to tell you that New Rochelle school system has some excellent programs. Like at the high school, we have the PAVE program, we have the science research program on our sports, our football, our cheerleading, and some of these programs are really excellent. But I want to speak on sort of the academic side, especially for, let's get more for the high school. You know, so when you've done work in other districts in New York City, what have you done to take over a situation and build on whatever the strengths are?
You really have to pore over the data, and then you have to look at where the areas of strength are and where are the areas of weakness. I've looked at the attendance data in the high school. I've seen some of the disproportionality in the special education data. Those are things you want to pinpoint and figure out then, based on the data, how do we look at the programs? How do we review the programs? There is no magic wand to solving any one of these problems. It's student by student. And it's figuring out what students need to give them access to the same opportunities, to support them so that they're successful in those opportunities, and what are the things we do to make sure kids want to come here and be in school every day. It seems like the kids that are in school are doing really well. And so there's a group of students we really need to figure out what we can do to support them inside of schools and get them coming back to school.
Well, but I'm also talking about the programs that are well regarded for the students who are coming to school and are, you know, into the system, and if the families have really committed to the district. There is some concern that some of the best programs in the school district, whether it's the AP Honors Track or whether it's the arts program, that you know, maybe they're going to be sort of, there's a term, de-leveled or whatever like that. So I just wanted to get this idea that it's more like about bootstrapping, right? We have some things here that we do really, really well. I would assume that you looked at the district enough to know that there's some things that we do really well. So how do you, when you go into a new job, a new district or new districts, we talked about that too, how do you, you know, build on the successes that the school or the district's already had?
Well, I'll tell you the secret. First thing to do is talk to the students. They know what they like, they know what they've been successful at, and they know the intricate ways that we can improve any program, make a great program better, and provide more opportunity for that program. And even students who are in the middle, which are sometimes the ones we forget, they know what they need to be able to access, especially when you're talking about high school students. I think it's true for every grade level, what they need and what would support them in order to improve or to move forward or get access to programs. So the students are our first entry point to figuring out what we can do. Certainly the teachers and the staff as well, to be able to support what they need to be able to move the programs forward. I think we're lifting up every single kid, and that's the opportunity that we have here, especially when there's great things going on and kids aspiring to be a part of that and raising those programs up as well.
Okay, so I remember, I think you mentioned Brooklyn.
Yes.
Okay. So I'm going to shift off inside school stuff. So one of the things we have going on here is touch on Brooklyn a little bit, which is this is probably the hottest development area in Westchester County, certainly, and maybe all of New York State right now, like Brooklyn has been. And so you have this issue of kind of working with the city government, working with developers, dealing with what the projections are going to be for schools and stuff like that. So there's a lot of people that are looking at the district. They don't have any kids here. Maybe they never did. Maybe they never will. You know, they're living in a two-bedroom apartment. So, you know, what have you done, you know, in working in the city to work with the city government, to work with planning and developers and stuff like that? Because whatever they do, you end up getting the result. And it's a public school. You don't get to pick and choose. So there has to be some coordination. And that's a big concern a lot of people have, is how does the school district work with the city, the developers? So can you speak about what your experience has been and how you might apply that here?
So in communities like New Rochelle, or in some of the communities in Brooklyn that I worked in, everyone's invested in the schools. A lot of times the communities are defined by their schools. So whether or not people have children in school, they are taxpayers, they care about their schools, they care about their community, and the value that schools and the next generation bring to that community. And so it's not just about parents and families and students, which is of course our priority. It's about working with senior citizen centers. It's about working with the elected officials. It's about being a little bit a part of community boards so that we can see where the development is. It's about partnering in a community to make sure that everybody's voice is heard, because everybody really does care about the schools, whether or not they have children in there.
Did you have an opportunity to meet people like the mayor, the development commissioner, the city manager, those folks?
I had an opportunity to meet the mayor.
Okay.
I will, across the time before I get here officially on November 1st, take as many opportunities as possible, maintaining my current position, but as many opportunities as possible to come here on days to be able to meet more community members and to be able to get to know some things before I actually get here.
Okay.
So I haven't met some of the other people, but I hope to be able to do that in the coming months.
But the mayor is always full of helpful advice.
He was.
What advice did he give you that you can share? What was his tip? Or tips?
I really only met him a very short time. He said what everyone else said. New Rochelle is a great place to be. Everyone cares. Everyone has a voice because they care. And that we'll work together to figure out the things that we need to do as partners in this work.
You found out that New Rochellians aren't shy.
They are not shy, but I like when people are upfront and speak their truth and talk about the things that they're interested in, their hopes, their dreams, and their concerns, because that's how we can better think about what the community wants and be a part of that community together.
Okay. So September's close,
mm-hmm.
right? And so parents will be coming back into the schools, the teachers will be reporting back. So between, you know, the beginning of school and the superintendent's day's conference, and when you're actually starting full time, what are they going to see? Are you going to be in the buildings? Are you going to be at PTA meetings? Are you going to be at a meeting with the teachers? What are you going to do over the next few months?
So all of the dates have not been decided. I will be here for opening day of school. That is the most exciting day of the school of the year. I will be here for opening day and a couple other opportunities to be able to meet people. Before I actually get started, I want the school year to get started well, and I'd like to be a part of it as much as possible.
Okay, that's good. That's all I got. Thank you so much. Appreciate it.